Hello there and welcome to the new Power BI tutorial video. And in this Power BI tutorial video, I will show you the calculate table function. Calculate table function is a very useful one, which probably you will use it once you get to know about it, because it helps you create a new table or a virtual table based on a given condition. Many times, from the existing table, you may want to create a whole together new table. For example, let's say you have this table, which I am using the orders table. If I go into this data mode, then you will see that a lot of table, the columns are present like order date, priority, ship mode, customer name, province, region, whatnot, right? Now, you may have a scenario, let's say you want to get only the low order priority, or you want to get only those orders where sales is greater than $100, let's say for that particular reason. So in those scenarios, the calculate table will come very handy, where you will have your main table orders along with the another table that will sit beside to this order table. All right, so how do you do that? Well, for that particular scenario, you go into the modeling, right, and come over here, write a DEX expression to create a new table, and table we will going to create using the calculate table. So what I will going to write is high sales value order, high underscore sales is I will say, and I will write this calculate table. As you can see, it evaluates a table expression in the context modified by filter. So I press tab to complete the calculate table function. Now I need to specify the table, and the table that we have is the order. And now I have to specify filter. I can specify one filter or I can specify multiple filter. Now, since we are just looking at it very first time, I will keep it simple. And I will say order sales is greater than 500, right? So all in all, what it is basically saying is create a new table where from the orders table where order sales is greater than 500. So what I have just done is, if you are coming from the SQL background, I have just translated the calculate table to you in a SQL query format. All right, so once I press enter, it will do the processing, and you would see the high underscore sales table is present here. Now you can see how handy or how useful it can become in scenario like those where you don't want to touch your main table, but you want to create tables out of the main table based on a specific condition or a specific business scenario for which you want to keep the records separate. All right, so once I come over here in this data, you see the high sales, and over here you will see the sales that is greater than basically of 500. So over here, if you see, you have got 540, 583. So whatever be the sales amount, if I just click over here, you will see that it will start from 500 and goes all the way up to that whatever is the maximum sales value is, up until the end, which is 945. Now if you see, if I come over here in the orders table, you have orders table intact and nothing is coming over here as come to the filter. You have all the order values, right? So both of these tables are present. And similarly, if you want, you can create new tables. So for example, as an exercise, what you should do is, why don't you go ahead and create the low order priority table as one table, give it a name, low order priority, and from the shipping mode, create one table where it is delivered by Express Air, right? So that's something you can do as a two different exercises for this particular scenario. Now, there is one more way by which you can use the calculate table function, and that is by creating a new measure. So in a similar way, if you don't need a table, but if you want to create a measure that you can use it anywhere in the chart or visualization, you can use that. So once you click it over here on the new measure, And you will say, let's say for example, high sales. Again, I am using the same basically way to calculate using the calculate table function. So now I will wrap the calculate table into the sumx because I am creating a measure, and measure only returns one value, right? One value or basically the aggregated value. So in that case, I will use calculate table, and in that calculate table, I will specify what I want, because if you see over here, I need to first specify the table, which is orders, and then I will say high order sales is greater than, let's say, 500. All right, I am done. So within the sumx, I have got this table already created, and now I can choose whatever expression I want. So here I want to calculate the sales back to based on the condition that is being specified over here. So once you do that, click this, come to the chart over here. Now if you see, the high sales is part of the order table, not something which is separate, right? So what I'll do is I will create this card and I will use the high sales over here. So whatever is the highest sale, the sales aggregated value, which is more than 500, is coming over here. Now what I'll do is I will create the another card and I will just take the normal sales, which is here. All right, this is coming same, which is not the expected behavior. So let me just go it over here very quickly and see. So order high sales is greater than, okay, maybe what I need to do is I need to use the order sales over here. That's probably the mistake which I have done. Okay, I'll say sales, which I should pick it up from order sales. This one greater than 500 and then order sales. Because of this condition, it was not satisfying, so it was picking up the entire value. Now it should pick the right value. And if I just get, and now you will see it has changed to 14.11 million. So overall sales value is 14.9 and 14.11. So remember this, you can also do maybe a similar mistake when you are in the environment and you may wonder what's going on. So the best way is, or the normal way or the standard way, is to just go back and look at the definition. So if something incorrect that you have specified, you will have to come back and do it again here. So these are the two different scenarios I wanted to show you, that how you can create altogether separate table as well as a measure based on the calculate table expression, which you can use it very easily within your Power BI environment for creation of the tables or charts or visualization. So that's mainly about it I wanted to show you. Let me know what do you think about this video. If you liked it, hit the like button and subscribe to my channel to keep getting the videos like this, and keep suggesting me if you have any new content idea. I'll try to create a video out of it. Thank you.